Good morning, class 10th. So today we are going to do our topic, how do acids and bases react with the metals? So first we will study the reaction of acids with the metal. About the metals, we have already studied in the previous classes, like iron, silver, gold, copper, aluminium. All these are the different type of metals which are present all around us, okay? And in the laboratory, the acids which are most commonly used are the hydrochloric acids, that is HCl, sulfuric acid H2SO4, and nitric acid which is HNO3. Okay, now here we will do the activity with the help of sulfuric acid only, and dilute sulfuric acid we will use. Okay, dilute sulfuric acid means we have added a little quantity of the sulfuric acid to the water so that to lower down its strength, or we can say we have used here weak sulfuric acid. Okay, now we will try to understand the activity with the help of this diagram. Look at the diagram carefully. Here we have arranged a setup in which we have taken a stand to hold this test tube. Okay, in the test tube what we have taken? Here we have taken the dilute sulfuric acid. The pale yellow liquid that you can see in the test tube is the dilute sulfuric acid. Then we have added a few pieces of the zinc metal to it, okay, to study our chemical reaction. Next, what we have done, we have closed the opening of mouth of the test tube with the help of this cork, this brown color object that you can see is the cork. It is made up of rubber and used for closing the opening of or mouth of the test tube. Here there is a hole in the cork so that to fit any delivery tube into it, so that if in case any gas or is produced as a product of the chemical reaction, it will get collected and delivered from this delivery tube to the any other container or to test that gas, okay, which we will study later on in this activity. Now this is the delivery tube which is made up of glass, okay. So we have fitted its one end into the cork, okay, and other end is here, which we have left in the beaker which is containing the soap solution. Okay, the blue color liquid that you can see in this container is the soap solution. Okay, now what we will do, as we added the zinc metal to the sulfuric acid here in the test tube, what we observe that bubbles are started forming at the bottom of the test tube, which will get lifted up from the bottom of the test tube to the top of the test tube. Now presence of bubbles clearly indicate that a gas is produced in the chemical reaction. Now gas will always lifted up from the liquid to the empty space. Now this gas will produce, and as the time passes, the more gas will be produced, which will get collected in the empty space present in the test tube. This is the empty space. Here this gas will get collected. Now here is the opening of this delivery tube. As the gas will produce, it will get delivered through this delivery tube to this soap solution. Now again, soap solution is a liquid. When gas will passes through the liquid, then bubbles will formed and it will get lifted up into the air. Okay, now we will test that which gas is produced. It is clearly indicated that gas is produced, but we are not sure that which gas it is. How we will confirm it, that which gas is produced when acid is reacting with the metal? For that, what we will do, we will take a burning candle near this gas. Okay, this is the burning candle. We will take this burning candle near this gas. As we take this burning candle near the gas, there will be a small explosion with a pop-up sound. Okay, now this pop-up sound is produced because of burning of hydrogen gas in the air. Okay, Now, it is only the hydrogen gas which burn in the air with a little explosion and produce the pop-up sound. Okay, so it is confirmed here that when the acid react with the metal, then hydrogen gas is produced. So hydrogen gas is one of our product, and second product is metal salt, which will left behind in the test tube. Okay, now here we have taken the zinc metal and had sulfuric acid. So zinc metal salt will get produced here. Okay, so these are our two products. In the same way, we can perform the activity with any other metal or any other acid taken. Suppose we have taken the zinc metal and we change the acid here with the dilute sulfuric acid HCl. Now the same reaction will take place. The products that we get is the salt of zinc metal, which will be ZnCl2. What the zinc metal will do? It is more reactive than this hydrogen. So here the displacement reaction will take place. This zinc atom will displace the hydrogen atom. Okay, the bond between the let me explain again. When the zinc metal will react with the hydrochloric acid, as this zinc is stronger than hydrogen, so what it will do, it will displace this hydrogen from its place. Bond between the hydrogen and Cl will get break, and zinc will form the bond with the Cl atom and produce the zinc salt ZnCl2. But zinc will react with the two atoms of chlorine, so here we will put 2. This indicates that one zinc atom reacts with the two hydrogen atom and two chlorine atom, right? So see, one product is zinc chloride, zinc salt. Now these two hydrogen atoms will get reacted to itself and will produce the hydrogen gas. Okay, so this is the chemical reaction for the process taken place, right? So here we have the two reactant, metal and acid, and two products, metal salt and hydrogen gas. I hope it is now clear to you. We will try to understand the activity with the help of a practical also. I will upload a separate video of it, and you can go through it for the better understanding. Okay, now the general reaction we can write here is metal plus acid. When acid react with the metal, it produces the salt and hydrogen gas. Okay, so it is clear to you. Next, this in the same way we will study the reaction of bases with the metal. For this we have taken here example. Look at the chemical reaction here. Now in this reaction, sodium hydroxide, it is the base that we have taken. In the bracket there is a symbol AQ, aqueous. Aqueous means solution of sodium hydroxide in the water. Okay, zinc metal is taken. S is for solid form, right? Zinc pieces are taken which are in solid state. Now these are two reactants, base and metal. When both these two reacts, then they give us two products, and these two products are number one, sodium zincate. Okay, second one again is hydrogen gas. So it is very much clear again that when metals react with bases, then they produce the hydrogen gas here. But the difference is these reactions is not possible with all the metals. A few of the metals only react with the bases to produce the hydrogen gas, but not all the metals. But in case of acids, all the metals, maximum of metals react with the acid to produce the hydrogen gas and their respective salts. Okay, I hope now this topic is clear to you. In case of any query, you can leave a message in the comment box. Thank you so much.